Hey, welcome to another video. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to use OBS as a virtual camera for your Zoom meetings or Skype meetings or whatever other type of meetings that you do where you actually need to share your screen or be on camera. My name is Burhan and I help my clients all around the world with their Zoom meetings, with their businesses, just basically making a living online, basically growing their business. If you like the channel, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss another video. And I'm going to get into sort of using OBS, which if you don't know is open broadcast software, and how OBS can actually use or has this new feature called a virtual camera to actually share that to your Zoom or to Skype or whatever else, so that you can get a little bit more professional and have a few fancy things on your Zoom meetings. Why OBS? So OBS One is free. It's a software that's been developed over years and years. The software has evolved over time. A lot of people are using OBS for live streaming on Twitch and YouTube and on Facebook. OBS has just updated the software so that to include the virtual camera. And what a virtual camera is basically OBS becomes a virtual camera or a camera source, as if you were plugging in this camera into your computer and shows Zoom or shows Skype or shows any of the other software that you might be using, that OBS is a camera. Basically, anything that you add into your Zoom scenes or into your Zoom windows as sources, then that will show up on your Zoom. Now, that's really cool and really nice because one, OBS gives you the ability to switch scenes and to maybe add a few elements that are a little bit more interesting, such as transitions or fancy widgets that you can actually add different graphics to your page, or maybe a lower third. Maybe you wanted to play a video, and so that allows you to do that from OBS, where you don't actually have to be sharing your screen between multiple windows and potentially your camera gets stuck or, you know, whatever the issues are with Zoom. So Zoom is a great software and Skype as well. But I feel like to add a little bit more professionalism to your Zoom meetings or to your Skype meetings, this can be a feature that would definitely be useful to you. Another thing that OBS also does is record videos. So I'm actually recording this video directly on OBS. So when I switch to the next scene, you're going to see OBS, and I'm going to show you actually how to get all of this done. So I'm sharing my screen, and you must have seen on the other window as well, on the previous scene, that I've actually got these little fancy widget here. I've got my camera showing up here in the corner. I've got, obviously, I'm sharing my desktop to OBS, and that's done through a number of different sources that are actually set up in OBS. I'm not going to go through how OBS works and how to set up these scenes, because there's a ton of videos on the internet on actually how to use OBS. One of the things that I think is interesting is that they've now added this Start Virtual Camera button. So if I go ahead and do this, and obviously I'm recording right now, so this might get a bit interesting, but if I start my virtual camera, and you can see that it started because now it says stop. And if I actually open Zoom, so I'm going to start a new meeting from scratch here, you're going to see my window, right? You're going to see exactly what you see on OBS. And the reason why that is because if I go here to switch my camera, I've got this OBS virtual camera selected. Basically, anything that I add in here into OBS is going to show up on Zoom. So for example, if I decide that I wanted my StreamElements browser source, and I'll go into what StreamElements right now is, you'll see that this little widget here in the corner has actually disappeared. So if I add that back in and I select it and I hit refresh, it's going to now start playing again. Now what this actually is a widget from StreamElements. Let's go to StreamElements quickly. This is StreamElements, and if you go to StreamElements.com, the link will be in the description. StreamElements is basically used for broadcasting mainly on Twitch, on YouTube, but you can, if you have a YouTube account or a Gmail account, you can actually sign in with a YouTube channel and start creating this widget. So obviously I'm on the dashboard right now, but the way to do the widget or add that specific widget in the corner of the video is if I go to the theme gallery. I'm going to give that a second to load up. And if I go here to widgets, you'll see right at the bottom here, there's the social media rotator. And there's a bunch of other sort of widgets that are used for, you know, subscriptions or emotes or, you know, leveling up things, different alerts for, you know, when somebody subscribes or when somebody, you know, follows your channel, whatever the case may be on Twitch. But what we're going to do right now, because this is specifically for Zoom, is I want to create this little lower third type of thing that it's a rotating widget that will basically show my social media accounts. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on that, click create, and I'm going to create a new overlay called OBS Virtual Camera Recording, just because it makes it easy for me to remember. StreamElements has given me this URL, and so if I switch back to OBS so they can show you how to do that. All right, so in OBS now, I'm going to add a new source because this is a browser source. So I'm going to add browser, and I'm just going to call it StreamElements OBS Virtual Camera, so VC. Okay, and now what it's done is it's given me this pop-up window that says, ask me the URL. So I'm going to paste that URL that I just got from from StreamElements in. I'm going to change the size to 1920 by 1080 because that's the size that I'm using in OBS. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move this OBS window a little bit so that you can actually see the name show up in the top left corner. So this is the default widget that is now showing up on this display. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to StreamElements and I'm going to go and customize this widget. And you'll see this widget change as I'm editing it. So if I scroll down in OBS, you're going to see this OBS virtual camera recording widget that I've just created 2 minutes ago. So I'm going to edit this one and it's going to open up the StreamElements editor. So just to give you a bit of a sense, so this is basically the entire canvas that I'm working on, and that's basically the 1920 by 1080 size that I've got in OBS. And so if I just move this over and hit save, you'll see automatically that the name has moved to a different location on the actual video that's now recording. So if I go to edit this, I'm going to click on this, or I can click on the widget and I hit settings. Now you're going to see various things that I can customize. So I can go and change the font, and I like to use Lato. Let's hit L, and I'm going to scroll down to look for it. So there's Lato, and I'm going to maybe change the size to 40 because that's a little large. So that's now changed, and I'm going to go down and change the Twitter name to my actual Twitter handle, like I have in, that's one I want to show as my handle. Of course, you can use whatever you want to use. So that's for Twitter. For YouTube, which is the second one, it's exactly the same. For Instagram, I am going to change it to that. And for Instagram, I noticed that the icon was actually Twitch as well. I'm going to change the Twitch name. Twitch name is here, right? I'm not going to change the font awesome icon because I'm happy with these icons. And I did notice that we had icon first for Instagram. That's fine. Here we've got the name first for YouTube. So I actually want to change that to icon first for YouTube. And so we'll see that update here in the next couple of seconds. There you go. That's basically how you would customize these. Change the positioning of this. Hit save. And as soon as you hit save, because it's linked to this browser source, right? If you hit the button here, you copy the overlay URL. And because it's inside of OBS, now you'll see that OBS has been updated. So if I go back to the display window, you'll see that this widget is now on the video on OBS. And of course, it is showing up on Zoom. So if I just move this window open, you'll see Zoom here on the right-hand side over here, and it is showing up in this window over here. In StreamElements, you can add graphics, you can add images, you can add videos with clear backgrounds. You can create an overlay that maybe has you on the left-hand side and somebody else on the right-hand side. And so from Skype or from Zoom, if you're arranging the windows in such a way that your recording is done that way, then you can use OBS, switch your screens, and to do some fancy things when you're actually recording the interview. So it makes it really simple, it makes it really easy. And because you've got the ability to add different camera sources inside of OBS and then just stream that specifically to Zoom, you can do a lot of different creative things to make your Zoom meetings a little bit more interesting, to make them a little bit more professional, and so that you're not fumbling around with the screen share button and trying to select a different window and trying to select different things. The other thing about OBS is it records video, which is what I'm doing right now. You can record in whatever format you want, have it edited by an editor or edit that yourself. I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it informative. If you did, comment below and let me know if you're considering using the virtual cam feature to actually either live stream or at least record your videos on YouTube. for YouTube, like the way that I'm doing right now, or maybe, you know, using virtual camera for Zoom or Skype. I think it's going to give you an added a little bit of professionalism, maybe, to your meetings. So with that being said, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss more videos. I go live on Twitch three days a week, where I'm playing games with my family and just interacting with the audience. If you have any questions, you can come over to my Twitch. The link is in the description. And yeah, we'll see you guys on the next video. Do comment below and let me know what you thought. Thank you so much. Bye-bye for now.